Basakana.
Basakana.
My brother Louis, who has moved with the entry of
Louis.
My brother John Senyoni, the spokesperson of People Power Movement. My brother and the comrade in the struggle, Honorable Zake Francis from the
Temple.
He's a survivor of Arua. We are on the church, some church with me and the, our brother Robert Chagulanyi. Of course, General Mugisha Muntu is known to you, is here with us.
General Mugisha Muntu,
my brother Robert Chagulanyi.
Muganda wange Robert Chagulanyi.
And your entrance?
Ne bango bodi na bo.
You are welcome.
Tumanirisa.
In the interest of time, I want that subtitle to invite my brother Robert Chagulanyi.
Njagala kutwala omukisa guno okwaniriza muganda wange Robert Chagulanyi.
To speak to our people.
Okwogereri abantu baffe.
Because I know he's moving for the better, and for me, I'm still here with you. I'll make my speech later.
Kubanga mani alina kufuna njumura kwa kigeto kora atenze ganchari wanonja kuwa kogira kwa angenja.
Honorable Robert Chagulanyi.
Uganda. OHTBwa Robert Chagulanyi Center.
God is good all the time. Amazing grace, how sweet is God. God is good, brothers and sisters. God is good. And all the time, I'm very, very humbled to be here today. I want to give my special thanks to Pastor Mwanguzi for the invitation. And I want to thank Pastor Drinkard for the amazing words you got today. It's not an ordinary day today, ladies and gentlemen. Like Pastor Mwanguzi explained, I was supposed to be here with you, celebrating and enjoying the love and fellowship of God with
you.
But we are only human beings. While we plan, the Almighty makes the grand plan. We were planning to share so many words with you, ladies and gentlemen. But like he told you, one of our comrades lost a father and we have to go to Tambala for burial. We are supposed to be sad for that. But we thank God still. Because our human eye only sees the negative. But God's plan is always a better plan.
Also.
So much as I will not be able to say all that I wanted to say today, at least I will get a few minutes to share a word with you, and at the same time use this unfortunate opportunity to also say a word to the people of Butambala. When Pastor Drinkard was preaching, It was like he was talking about my life. I was looking at a soldier. Because soldiers mainly, their job is to fight. And military fighting includes death and killing. But here I was looking at an ex-soldier preaching the word of God to us. It communicated to me personally. Because, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not the most qualified person to be talking to you in the presence of God. I am but just a ghetto child. But ultimately, God pointed out reason for my life, and that is why I am standing before you and will be standing before so many people to communicate what I believe God wants them to hear. So this morning I'll talk about only three things. And I'll have the confidence to say the things I'm going to say. Because I am in the house of God. I am in my Father's house. And when I'm in my Father's house, I don't fear no evil. Ladies and gentlemen, we must be alive to where we are today. Back in the days, communication and guidance to God's people came through the prophets and the preachers of the Holy Word. And we know right from the words, right from the days of Jesus, that we had great, great kings that had superpower. When reading the Bible, I'm not an expert in the Bible, but a few stories that inspired me from the Holy Book. I read about a great king called Pharaoh in Egypt. No matter what he did to show his power and exert his power on the people of God, on the children of God, ultimately, the power of God took precedent. Through the men and women of God that stood by God's will. There was a king called Nebuchadnezzar, who everybody was
of a king. Pastor, you guide me when if I don't get it right, but there was a king called Ahab.
Ahab.
Yeah, he was a king called Ahab, who so many of the prophets were scared of. And every prophet was telling King Ahab what King Ahab wanted to hear. And there's only one prophet that King Ahab hated so much. Because he always told him the truth. I don't remember the name of that prophet.
Micaiah, yes.
Micaiah.
But because God was with the prophet Micaiah, that prophet Micaiah did not fear no evil. And ultimately, even though King Ahab was lied to by so many prophets, prophet Micaiah told him the truth. King Ahab arrested that prophet and put him in jail. But what that prophet told King Ahab came to pass. because King Ahab ultimately was killed in the war. What am I trying to say, ladies? Today you notice, especially from the ghetto where I come from, that so many young men and women are distancing themselves from the church. So many young men and women are doubting the authenticity of the gospel. Because the gospel is being edited so many times to appease those that have the power today. God uses his people to preach goodness and unleash goodness to his sons and daughters on planet
Earth.
So if we have leaders that are behaving like Nebuchadnezzar today, if we have leaders that are behaving like Pharaoh today, if we have leaders whose actions are not reflecting the will of God today, then it is the job of those men and women of God to call those leaders to order. It is the job of those men and women to remind those leaders that there have been great and stronger leaders than them before. It is the duty of those leaders in church to always remember that they serve a living God, a stronger God than the mortals they fear. To stand by the truth, because the truth will set you free. Today, we get the opportunity to communicate to you in church, because this same truth that we are telling you, we are not allowed to tell people out there. I am personally convinced that some of us are still alive by the grace of God, not by our power, not by our wisdom, by the grace of God. So it is very, very important, brothers and sisters, that we get that confidence. If we cannot get the confidence from the parliament, if we cannot get the confidence from the courts of law, at least let us be reminded and remind other people that we can get confidence from the Almighty God. Finally, I am always inspired by the story of the great King David. And I know all of you, no matter what kind, how different and divergent the challenges you're facing are, there is a David story in your life. And there's a Goliath character in your life. It might be your financial status that is your Goliath you're facing, and the poverty you are facing is as strong as Goliath. You don't have any hope of overcoming it. Your Goliath might be a disease that you're suffering from. Mainly, our Goliath, generally as Uganda, is the leadership that is oppressive, that we want to change and make the leadership of this country reflect the will of God. Because, ladies and gentlemen, many of us were not born yet, but our forefathers chose a beautiful motto for our country.
kyaffe balonda moto ennungi ey'eggwanga lyaffe
for God and our country
olwa Katonda n'ensi yaffe
for God and our country
olwa Katonda n'ensi yaffe
so while we face all these challenges let us be reminded by the story of David who overcome
Goliath
not with missiles not with machine guns but with a mere stone allow me speak a little bit of Luganda basebo ne banyabo Kyamukisa mubi nti ngenda kuleka omukolo guno omulungi ennyo nga gukyagenda mu maaso ng'obubidda mu luzungu. Njagadde njogereko nammwe mu Luganda njogekozesa luzungu kuba nkakasa bannaffe bangi nnyo abatamanyi Luganda betulina. Naye baganda bange kirungi nnyo okwejjukiza naddala mmwe abaweereza ba Katonda. Nti bwe tuba tetusobola kufuna bugumu okuva mu zi paliamenti oba kuva mu makooti oba abantu bonna bonna mujjukire nti Katonda oyo gy'ali. Era olugolo lwa Dawudi oluzizaamu bajjajja ne bajjajja ne bajjajjaffe amaanyi oluzizaamu abantu ba Katonda amaanyi naffe tutuzengamu amaanyi. Kuba embeera gye tulimu basebo ne bannyabo tetwesiga muntu ne poliisi tetukyasobola kugamba nti tugyesiga. Tekyasobola kwesiga paliamenti naye twesiga Mukama Katonda. Era njagala okusaba oba okusomooza mwenna abasumba naddala abo abagenda okutikira olwaleero okuyimiriranga ku mazima naddala mweno Uganda ng'abasumba bangi batya omukulembeze okusinga bwe batya Katonda. Kikulu nnyo okumanya nti amazima gasigala mazima era abo abayimirira ku mazima ne bwe baba bafudde nga bafiiridde mu Katonda Bayibuli etugamba balibeera balamu emirembe gyonna. Njagala okumaliriza nga neebaza Pastor Mwanguzi olw'okutuyita nga neebaza babishopu bonna nga neebaza mungeri enjawulo Jeno Mugisha Muntu ne baganda befo bonna abamuwerekeddeko nammwe basebo ne bannyabo olw'okubeera naffe leero olw'okutuyita njagala okubaagaliza omukolo mulungi naye njagala mbalekere ekirowoozo kino nti twasalawo ffe kulumba nalo nga twesiga Mukama Katonda kuba ne Dawudi yakuba Goliyasi nga yeesize Mukama Katonda wajinyirira nga ye osobola kusaba tugwa mu manyi osobola manya Mukama wali osobola kuzuula mu mbeera yonna walinga entiisa nyingi osobola nga Mukama wali osobola kale gwe tugwa mu manyi osobola kuzuula mu mbeera yonna mwebale nnyo mwebale nga balinga nayo obusake nekyoebisomenyi ne Pasita Lubokoya n'abalala bonna bonna mpozi Pasita ngambye ngimubuuze nti nandyagadde ne nsaba ku Sande naye ate ne mpulira mintiisa
edda tusaba ero mu kanisa tewali kaguru
bantu bangi tunoonya mirembe eno naye mpulira ebizibu bisinga eno
edda kyanga n'osaba ero mu kanisa
mwebabatiza bantu bangi tunonya mirembe eno naye mpulira nammwe babatiza banange kambasabe okusaba kugenda maaso muzikirize manyi twina mikwano gyaffe mingi naye kye mumperekera leero okusaba kugenda maaso ngenda kyekwatagana emirimu emirala si kyekyo ate singa tetubadde mu kusaba nandigambe people power naye kansirife
Mukama yebazibwe abalokole.
Praise the Lord, church.
Katwalirize ab'emirimu gyaffe.